personalized medicine, where a drug is given to a patient based on or tailored to their genetic makeup, is an exciting area of research. We know very little about it, and personalized medicines come in many flavors.
So our group at the unit works on RNA therapeutics, and these are a really exciting new class of drugs which can be used to treat a wide range of diseases that currently don't have treatments. So a good example that everyone knows about of an RNA therapeutic that's widely used is COVID vaccines. However, there's a whole broad spectrum of different sizes of RNA therapeutics you can use.
We work with an RNA therapeutic called antisense oligonucleotide, or ASOs. So these are short stretches of RNA or DNA which are synthetic, and then when introduced into our cells can stop the production of faulty or undesired proteins even before they are made.
For example, Duchenne muscular dystrophy, where there is a single gene leading to a protein which is non-functioning. And with RNA therapeutics, we can target the instructions that lead to the production of this protein and prevent it from forming in the first place.
These ASOs, these medicines, are used to treat rare genetic diseases, but also common diseases such as cancer and neurodegeneration. The cause of these diseases are very different in different people, and hence we need to identify the drugs that actually suit the patient, which may be different for different patient groups. And that's what antisense oligonucleotides offer: personalized, tailored therapy for an individual. While these medicines have a huge potential and they're quite successful in clinical trials, they come with a caveat.
Just like any other advanced therapy, we need to address certain challenges like side effects,
instances of liver toxicity, kidney toxicity. And so we really need to understand what's causing this toxicity in patients in order to get more of these drugs approved and have the ability to treat some of these diseases.
There are many ways in which we can improve these new therapeutics. One is to identify better targets.
The ultimate aim is to prevent the onset of neurodegeneration, to prevent when people develop their first symptoms, because once neurons die, they cannot regenerate. So we need to know which genes we have to activate or inhibit in order to improve cellular resilience in the brain cells. Then we know if we can develop mRNA or ASO-based therapeutics to directly target specific genes in the brain to keep our brain cells healthy and resilient.
The second way to be able to get to safer drugs is actually to identify why is it that some people have issues with the safety, some people are okay, and then see if we can change the drug that we have with simple modifications.
So my PhD project was designed to look at liver toxicity, one of the main problems associated with these drugs in clinical trials. So we're in the microscopy room, and these high-powered microscopes allow us to look at a very, very powerful magnification, and we can see what's actually going on for ourselves. I'm looking at some liver cells today. We're dosing them with the RNA therapeutics that we're using, and we can fluorescently label the drugs to see exactly where they go. So you can see your nucleus very nicely in blue, and then in red are my RNA therapeutics, my ASOs. And when you overlay them, you can see, oh, are these drugs getting to the nucleus? Are they completely missing the cells? Are they being taken up by the cells? Those are the sort of questions that I wanna try and answer.
In my research, we are using CRISPR knockout libraries to understand how these ASOs are causing these toxic side effects. So what we are doing here is turning off different genes to find out which are protective against the ASOs and what are the genes that make our cells vulnerable to the ASOs. Then we can combine ASO therapies with other treatments that helps protect cells, making these treatments safer and more effective.
This work is really, really important because it allows us to understand these drugs better and to make them safer by design and have a real world impact for patients.
It is great to know that the work we do here has a potential to lead to novel therapeutics that can improve people's lives.
What I enjoy about my job the most is the sense of discovery, the fact that I get to learn something new every single day and can hopefully contribute to making treatment safer for patients.
The discoveries that we make in the lab will be useful for the entire world, all the population, all the doctors, all the drug companies to develop effective and safe therapeutics for treatment of myriad diseases, rare genetic diseases, neurodegeneration, and cancer.